So I took it apart, and yes, it was a bit messy. I think that's some silicone they've added there. There was a few metal shavings in the heat block, so I removed those. The way I understand it, your bottom tube has to sit flush with the heat break, and the nozzle has to sit flush with the heat break as well, inside the heat block. So what I can try to do is screw the nozzle as much as possible in the heat block, then screw the heat block onto the heat break, and thus they are flush, the heat break and the nozzle, but it doesn't look very square. So I'm going to unscrew the nozzle, screw the heat block a tad more, and screw the nozzle back to the heat break. So you can see now there's a small gap between where the nozzle is and the heat block, but I don't think it does matter. What matters is that the nozzle and the heat block are flush, and I can insert the bottom tube up to the end. Okay, so plan B. I didn't really like the fact that the nozzle wasn't flush with the heat block. That gap didn't convince me. I think it, since the melting happens right here, I don't want the end of the nozzle to be too far from the melting. So what I've done is I've screwed the nozzle tight against the heat block, then screwed the heat break tight against the nozzle, then slightly unscrewed the nozzle, slightly screwed the heat break, because I cannot get a good grip on that, so I'm gripping on the nozzle itself to make sure the gap is tight, and re-tightened the nozzle against the heat break. I'll do it one more time in many, many hours when the printer is ready to print and I'm hitting the heat block for the first time. But I think that's the best solution for now. And things are pretty square and level, which I like in my obsessive, compulsive, disorderly way. One more discovery: that black thing there that goes on top of the whole hotend assembly, just discovered it's acting kind of like a valve. It allows the bottom tube to go in, but not out. So when your extruder is retracting, even if there's a bit of friction between the filament and the bottom tube, you're sure the filament is never going to pull the tube from the heat block. And that's great. Really neat. So, but if you push on the black part, of course, you can release the tube.